lives.
Let's go.
Okay, so I'm Eric Leblanc. I'm one of Suricata developers. So for the one who were sleeping for the past 10 years, Suricata is an open source networked intrusion detection system that is developed by a foundation named OISF. So IDS are here since really long, since something like 20 years, sniffing the network and trying to find the bad guys, but in fact not. So I was doing an exercise somewhere, and we had a red team and a blue team, and I was asked, can you find when the blue team is attacking, where they go, and so we can see the progression of the blue team, the red team in the network. So all that using IDS alert from Suricata, and so I said, okay, so that's easy. I just need to find the path that are possible given the alert from one external node, which where the red team is, to the internal where the blue team and the network to protect is. So that's super easy. So one thing that could be really fancy to draw is a graph. It should be an oriented graph where you've got the source and target in the network and an edge between the source and the target, so you can see the path visually on the graph. So really easy. Okay. So for that, I can use the Suricata alert format in JSON, which is the following. So you got everything you need, like source IP, destination IP, and other parameters. The good thing that you also have some protocol information in the alert, so you don't need to analyze everything. You directly have the information available in the alert. So that's quite useful. So when I say you find the bad guys in an alert, you just say, oh, I'm going to use the source. So the source IP. So it works quite well. For instance, on this alert, we've got a scan, which is an nmap scan. We've got a verification of flag, and we've got the bad guy outside and the good guy inside, and we've got an alert. But sadly, that's just not true. You've got some signature that are written where the bad guy is the destination IP. So this means simply that we cannot trust the signature and we cannot build any more oriented graph. And we need to find something else. And the only thing that we can do is a Christmas tree. If I take my dataset and I ask you, find me the path that are really interesting, like a long progression in the network, you begin to be scared because you got a lot of points and no way to see the direction and something like that. That's really painful. So I decided to look at what other solutions we are doing. So first, the old one, Snort, is using quite the same language. It's got exactly the same problem. So that was a no-go. We cannot do the attribution like usual. And also check SourceFire to see if there is in the rule something that we can use. Nothing here, there's some metadata, but nothing that tell you this is a bad guy, this is a good guy. So Prelude, I don't know if you know it, it's IDEMF, it's using, it's defining source and target, but as you can see, the definition is quite fun because source definition is the source of the event. Okay, that's quite useful. And the implementation of Prelude is wrong, it's violated is on RFC, so that's bad. So I introduced in Suricata 4.0 a keyword which is named target, which allows you to say that the target of an attack is the source of destination IP in the alert. I updated the code, fixed the prelude output, and then extended the JSON output. So now in the JSON output, you've got this. If you've got a signature with a target keyword, then you've got inside the alert object, you've got the IP, the source, and the target IP. So you can use this value to do the graph that we wanted to do. So if we take the same graph, the same data set with the new information, what we can see is that what was looking before like a huge possible compromission chain, it's just in fact some linked node, but without any path. So this way, we can see clearly that it was not that a big attack on this network. So as a conclusion, this introduction of source and target as origin of the attack and destination of the attack will allow you to build better visualization, to do some more automated analysis to find some path inside the network. One of the big problems of this approach is that we need to update the rules. So I'm currently working with Emerging Threat, which is one of the bigger providers to do that, but something that we can convert. And we have just switched to Suricata 4.0 rule set, so that should be possible. And yes, evolution is to be able to use more advanced keyword, like when you've got an alert on SMTP, you don't really care about the destination, which is your SMTP server. What does matter is the email that has to be reached. So we will be able to evolve to that soon. And yeah, if you want to know more, you can come to Suricon, which is in Prague next month. If you've got questions, you can come to Suricon. If you've got money, you can sponsor it.
Okay, thanks very much. Thank you, Eric.